Let me give you an idea of how to plan, right, your responses. Now, you know that you're going to be asked, would you be interested to do this or that? So your opinion, Oreo starts with opinion, O, agree or disagree, right? That's quite straightforward, right? It is not wrong to disagree. It is not wrong to say, I am not interested. However, you'll find that you may not have a lot of things to say if you disagree. So you can be very honest and say, I really do not like to dance, right? Then how can you approach this? So even if you want to disagree, try to find a compelling reason why you disagree. So if I don't like to give a speech, it is because I have stage fright, right? So that's a legitimate reason. Now, when it comes to reason, Oreo R for reasons. I always tell students, please be prepared to tell your examiner two reasons before you open your mouth to speak. Because it is very terrifying for a student to only have one reason, finish saying that one reason, and then run out of reasons, and then you freeze. Okay, so if you at least have two reasons, use the first reason, you move to the second reason, and then at that point in time, if you really can't think of a third reason, move in to talk about your example, not your personal experience. Now, the personal experience, Oreo E, for examples, is the best part of, is the highlight of your answer. Why? Because an examiner would have heard 20, 30 students saying the same things over and over again. The only difference between each candidate is their personal experiences. So whether you have interesting experiences or not, the fact is, if you talk about yourself, right, you will actually leave an impression. And examiners actually like to hear different things come out of students, right? After the first five students, honestly, everyone is saying the same thing, right? So this is where you can catch your examiner's attention and where you can excel, right? So try to use an example that is relevant to the question. And even if you don't have a relevant example, talk about somebody you know who has that example, who has that experience, right? Original idea is what I mentioned just now about the top band, right? The introducing new ideas, taking initiative. So students who can do this well, right, tend to be able to score full marks for their conversation. Now, this is what I mean. So if it's the poster about a dance competition, right, and you're asked if you would like to participate in the dance competition. So you've given your Oreo, right, your opinion, your reasons why you like to take part, and then some examples of when you have taken part in something before, right? And then now introduce this idea that, but dancing may not be for everyone. I think another way for students to be engaged is to take part in guitar lessons or music lessons, or to take part in drama. So while it is related to taking part in something, you have introduced a new idea, right? So it may or may not be the following questions that you'll be asked, but you've already made yourself a little bit more interesting, right, than someone else who basically just answers the question in straightforward manner, right? Hi, this is Dr. Daniel Chua. I hope the video that you have just watched will be helpful to your child in preparation for PSLE English. So if you are interested to sign up for any of our programs, please feel free to check out this QR code, and then you can then find out more about what we do to help our students at Connectors Academy. All right, thank you.